Hi, hello everyone, welcome back to Vlogmas. What are we now? Day 6. I'm back at it with another gift ideas list, but this time for scientists. Science is a very broad term, so you are going to have to do some of the work here. Because there's just so many different types of science, it's really hard to actually put a gift list together that's gonna make everybody who likes science happy. So, to put into some context, I am a pharmacologist slash biologist, so biology themed things are my forte. I will list some other stuff because I do also like chemistry, I'm just not a chemist, and physics baffles me. Typical biologist is scared of physics, but I will try and list a few things if I can. Talk to the people you're buying gifts for. Ask them what they might want. If they are a student or they actively like learning things, if they're doing a doctorate, for example, or even if they're just an actual MD, ask if there are any textbooks that they want or if there's any textbooks they want money towards. So I'm the kind of nerd that really enjoyed getting textbooks as a gift because textbooks are expensive, but sometimes you just need them to pass your degree or to continue learning or to be the best doctor you can be. Now, education aside, let's move on to the fun things. More books, I'm afraid. Something I didn't know existed until I did is graphic novels about science. So I love these two in particular. So this is Neurocomic by Dr. Matteo Farinella and Dr. Hannah Ross. And it is basically just the basics of neuroscience, but in a graphic novel format, which actually really helped me in my degree. This is not a textbook, but it helped me understand the very basics so I could build on top of that. Because the way textbooks and my lecturers were doing it was just list after list after list of text after text. This helped so much. The next one is Science Tales by Daryl Cunningham, and it basically debunks some science myths. So there's got things about chiropractors. It's got things about chiropractors in, it's got things about homeopathy, do vaccines cause autism, and it is all properly referenced and researched. This is very good. Still some more book ideas. Sorry, I like books. It's just fun books about science. So I'm not a doctor, but I am chronically ill and all things medicine sort of really interest me. So I watch House, I like House. This is a book called Medicine's Strangest Cases and it's fascinating to read. I'm just really interested in like the history of medicine. So this is a good addition to that. And then this is a book called The Accidental Scientist. It is just about scientists who got lucky and found their big break. And it's hugely validating as a scientist to see that things don't always go to plan. This is just a really interesting read. So if you have people, especially young people that are interested in science and want to know more about science and the scientific process, this book. I also found this in a charity shop and thrifted gifts are okay. Next, and I'm sure you've seen these, you can get crockery in the shape of glassware and beakers and test tubes. Those are glassware, but you can get like shot glasses that are tiny miniature conical flasks and test tubes for doing shots, or you can even get big ones that are marketed as vases, or even just crockery or mugs with like chemical structures. This is my version of that. I have a coffee pot, there's beans in it, but it has that on it with coffee beans because coffee. Something like this would make a really cute gift. It's quirky and it's fun and it is vaguely sciencey. Without having to know too much about science, you can go in and be like, yes, science gift. On a similar note to the coffee pot, a mug. Buy them a mug with even just pharmacologist on it. It's a very niche market, pharmacologist, but a mug exists with anything on it. Like, if you've thought of it, you can put it on a mug. There is a mug for every single type of person. Scientists are included in that, so get them a mug. You don't have to have a massively deep understanding of the science that your friend is into to buy them a mug, because you could just say world's greatest chemist and that would do the job. Bonus points if you do have an understanding of the science and there is a joke or a pun on it, but any sort of mug with their theme of science on it is a good gift. Models. Models are fun and good, says the nerd. So models of things like the chemical structure of DNA, that is definitely a model that exists somewhere and I kind of want one. I think it's really cool. You can get models of the chemical structures of most things. You could get a Newton's cradle for your physicist friend. You could get anatomical models of brains and hearts and any other organs for people with an interest in anatomy. If you have a friend into archaeology and paleontology, you can get them a dinosaur model or even a dinosaur fossil. Solar system models exist as well for your physicist friends. If you have a chemist friend, Molly Mod kits so they can build their own. I'm not sure if everywhere calls them Molly Mod kits. I think they're called molecular modeling kits. Not really sure. But basically you've got little balls as the atoms for elements, and then you've got sticks for the bonds, and then you can just build your own structure of whatever you want to build a structure of. So you're not bound by what's popular, like caffeine or serotonin. You can pick something niche like propranolol if you wish. Jewelry also definitely exists. So while we're on the topic of popular chemicals, we've all seen the necklaces with the caffeine symbol on it, with the serotonin structure, with the dopamine structure. Those exist, but they also exist beyond just the popular things. I have seen a necklace, which I have my eye on, but it's expensive, of a GPCR, a G protein coupled receptor, on a necklace. I want one! I made one once out of shrink plastic. It didn't really go very well, but I wore it anyway. Oh god, I'm the biggest nerd you've ever seen. But I'm enthusiastic about my science, what can I say? So jewellery with that on, if your scientist friend is a jewellery wearer, please make sure that it's something that they can take off in the lab. Another one of the things that I enjoy collecting. More badges. More badges. Badges are good. I have a large collection of badges and it does not stop at deafness and hearing loss badges. I have science badges too. I'm just gonna start quickly with some enamel pins, and I have since, these were gifts, but I have since learned that most of the enamel pins that you find on the internet are stolen artwork, and through no fault of the person that gave me to them, I'm pretty sure that these are the knockoff version, so I will not be providing a link to these ones. There's one, it says rise above, focus on science. Quite a nerdy one, but this reminds me of my master's degree, is this looking down the microscope at some different cells. I also have this cool badge that says science is real, and then vaccines don't cause autism, and a shout out to have you booked your smear test because they are important, and Black Lives Matter, and super gay. Oh, and another deafness badge, here you go. Science badges exist and they make great gifts. Stuff that has the periodic table of elements on it, bonus points for spelling stuff. That is a sentence that I just didn't know how to make it work. So for example, a notebook personalized with the recipient's name on it, spelled with elements from the periodic table. Or on the notebook theme, world's greatest pharmacologist notebook. Scientists take notes a lot, so a notebook will be very helpful. And if you can get a science-themed notebook, excellent, excellent choice. Maybe to go alongside that, you can get science-themed stationery. So for example, as a pharmacologist, I have been gifted multiple times with mini highlighters in the shape of pills, which I love. Notebooks and stationery, always good. If they have a science theme, even better. And sort of study material. So I have this, which is a, it's like post-it notes. It says, be smart, left and right. Interesting choice, but it has things in it that I like. So, post-it notes. I like post-it notes, and there's different options, and there's some with a brain on it. It's just neat to have it all in a little thing, so I can put sticky notes easily in my textbook and they're gonna stay where I need them to stay, so I can learn, add to notes, and just be a nerd. I hate that you've seen this side of me now. That's all I've got on my list. I hope that this has been a broad enough list so that you can now go out and find something for your friend or relative, whoever you want to buy for, that is a scientist. So don't forget to like this video, drop a comment down below if you have anything to add to the list, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 p.m. UK time with at least one bonus video every single month, apart from this month where I'm doing Vlogmas, which is 25 videos in 25 days. See ya!